I'm Jared Haynes, and this is Yeti Paintball. Today I want to do a comparison between two arm pads that I've been wearing and testing. So I've got the Virtue Breakout on my right arm and the HK Crash HSTL on my left arm. Both these pads are gonna run you about $60, and they have quite a few common features, and they also have some major differences. So at the end, I'm gonna tell you which one is definitely the way I would recommend you go. First arm pad I wanna start off with is gonna be the HK Crash. So let's start up at the bicep, work our way down to the wrist. So up on the bicep, there is going to be a Velcro attachment point. That's gonna allow you to somewhat cinch this up. If you have a little bit bigger bicep than me, that's gonna work out perfect. And then up here at the top, and then running down the sides, you are going to have a neoprene material. That is definitely something that traps in the heat. But it does provide a really nice, sturdy feeling to the arm guard. On the inside of the forearm section, as we work our way down, you have kind of like a traditional Under Armour material. And then on the outside of the elbow and forearm, you're going to have a pretty heavy-duty padding. It's a dual-layered padding, and it keeps its own shape. So if you have a really big forearm, a lot bigger than mine, it would wrap around, I would assume, a little bit better. But as you can see on the one that I'm currently wearing, it is, you know, fairly form-fitting up here in the wrist and stuff. It's not like this is loose on my arm. And when you go to bend on the elbow, this jets out on both sides. It kind of pinches. The material doesn't wrap around. It kind of keeps its own form. Same on the outsides, it keeps that form. It's a pretty dense material. That isn't necessarily a negative or a positive. It kind of depends on what kind of material and feeling you want, and we'll get to that when we get to the Virtue. But let's go ahead and keep moving down with the HK. Now as we get farther down towards the wrist section, the padding is gonna stop. We're gonna rehab or pick up that neoprene. And then you do have padding on the back of the wrist, which is nice. There is a thumb hole down here on the hand. There is not like a padding on the lower section of your hand right here if you're diving, but there is that nice coverage on the back of your hand if you're holding on to the gun and you get shot right there. You're pretty well covered all the way up this arm. Now this padding, I would not say is the best at getting bounces. This is definitely more of an abrasion stopper. If you're diving or you get hit, you're not gonna feel that hit anywhere near as much. So it protects you from welts, those kind of things. It will obviously help. It's not like a solid material with bounces, but it's not the softest material out there if you're aiming more towards the bounce of a paintball and less on the overall protection side. Now moving on to the Virtue Breakout. This arm pad is gonna be similar form factor. We're gonna go ahead and start up at the top, move our way down to the wrist. So up on the top section, you'll notice there is not a Velcro tab up there. This just has elastic and kind of a rubber section in here to grab on to your skin or to a shirt or whatever you have underneath. The whole entire inside of this is a nice Under Armour type stretch material. So you have very good ventilation. Up top, you have a very lightweight and flexible pad right here, which is going to be mimicked right here on this portion above the elbow. As you move down into the elbow, you're going to get into a more dense material. However, unlike the Crash, this one, when you bend your arm, does not stay rigid. It definitely bends and molds with the shape of your elbow. I have pretty small arms, and this keeps a good shape on me and hugs the arm. As we move our way down past the elbow, we're gonna keep this same material all the way down, but it will narrow, and where it was just neoprene on the Crash, we have on the Breakout another pad that's inlaid in here, and that one is gonna be a different density than the back, and that gives really good protection if you're hitting and diving onto the side. And it still allows, because you have all that mesh on the inside, good ventilation. Then we're gonna get down into the wrist section. So down here in the wrist, you have kind of like a rubbery gel that's on the back right here and on the lower portion and thumb insert side, if you look right here. They say something that helps if you're crawling or something like that. I don't think that it really helps if you're crawling, but it does give good grip if you're up against a barrier or if you have your hand up against the tank or your gun or whatever, you know, in some sort of a weird handhold. That will definitely add just a little bit of extra safety that your hand's not gonna slip off of something. And then there are two pads right here that have a nice split in the palm section so that it molds around your hand really well. And that is something that the Crash does not have. This one has the pads on the back, and this one doesn't have anything on the back of your palm, but it does have on the side for hitting and diving. So that would be kind of a preference thing. You would have to decide which one you like the best. The wrist mobility in these, you have a lot more wrist mobility on the Virtue, but you have more wrist stability if you wanted something to kind of mimic like a brace or something like that on the HK Crash. And then when it comes to the overall weight, you're looking at a pretty significant weight feeling difference between these two. I haven't actually weighed them to find out what the exact weight difference is, but the Virtue is considerably lighter and traps in a lot less heat than the Crash does. So for me personally, if you're looking between one of these two, I would go and prefer the Virtue Breakout. It's lighter weight, still gives that good protection on the backside. I'm more trying to have a little bit of recoil dampening if I'm sliding, hit my elbow or dive or something like that. But mostly I'm more going for welt coverage to try and stop getting a bunch of welts on my arm on those close-up shots. If you're behind a bunker, somebody comes around, bunkers you, or what's the thing that's constantly popping out the most? It's gonna be those arms. So this gives me the best chance of a bounce as well as stops those welts because I have a normal day job and it looks kind of goofy if you're coming into work with welts all over. The HK Crash definitely gives that good protection, but traps in a little bit more heat. I'm gonna go ahead and pull this off really quick. And it's not something you're gonna be able to see, but my arm down the sides where the neoprene was on the Crash is starting to get a little bit of a, you know, about to sweat, almost that damp kind of feeling, as where if I pull off the Virtue Breakout, I have absolutely none of that, you know, dampness, ready to sweat feeling, just because it has a lot more of the mesh and it doesn't have any of the neoprene on there. My last closing thought on this is gonna be for about $60. I think either one of these is a good choice. They both have good pros and cons to each one. And for the sizing, both are small mediums. I am 5'10", about 148 pounds. So I'm a pretty thin guy. My arms are pretty skinny. And these, I'm on the lower end of the small medium size for having them fit. I would definitely not go any smaller if they did have a smaller option, but they do fit down pretty low. And because of how much stretch they have, I would imagine can get a decent amount wider, you know, bicep and forearm and stuff like that. So I hope you liked this review. If you did, please consider liking and subscribing to the channel for more content like this coming out soon. Thank you for watching.